Tag TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.
You're watching South Asia Newsline and here are the top stories we are tracking for you on Friday, the 5th of April. Indian Army foils infiltration bid along LOC, operation underway. Activists raise concern over human rights situation in POK, Gilgit-Baltistan. And IMF says there is strong expectation of Sri Lanka commercial creditor deal. And now for all the details. In a joint operation on Friday, security forces foiled an infiltration attempt and neutralized one terrorist along the line of control in Uri sector of India's Jammu and Kashmir. In a post on X, the Indian Army's Chinar Corps said troops deployed along the LOC foiled the infiltration attempt in early hours of Friday after suspecting a movement through Sabura Nala in the Uri sector. The statement confirmed one terrorist was eliminated and the operation was still in progress. India has long blamed Pakistan aids terrorists to disrupt peace and stability in the region. The Uri sector, situated near the line of control, the de facto border between India and Pakistan, has been a frequent target of such infiltration attempts. However, Islamabad denies the accusation. And giving a stern response to the UN, India's Foreign Minister S. Jaishankar on Thursday said that the global body does not need to tell him that the elections in the country should be fair and free. Jaishankar's comments came in response to a query regarding a statement of the UN Secretary General spokesperson stating that they hope in India, people's political and civil rights are protected and everyone is able to vote in a free and fair atmosphere. Jaishankar further said that the people of India will ensure that elections are free and fair, so the UN has not to worry about it. The elections across India will be held in 7 phases between April 19 and June 1, and votes will be counted on 4th of June.
The spokesperson of the United Nations was asked about, in a very loaded manner, because, half the problem is the person asking the question, it is not the person replying to the question. So the United Nations spokesman said something to the effect, in India, like in any other country, we hope the democratic process would be free and fair, etc. But in India, I don't need the United Nations to tell me our election should be free and fair. No, I have the people of India. The people of India will ensure the elections are free and fair. So don't worry about it.
Meanwhile, India's main opposition Congress party on Friday promised to lift a cap on affirmative action for marginalized communities if it wins power in elections starting this month. Releasing its election manifesto, Nyay Patra, the grand old party said it will bring a constitutional amendment to raise the 50% limitation on reservation for SC, ST and OBC communities, along with a pledge to conduct nationwide socio-economic and caste census. The manifesto also promised scrapping of Agnipath recruitment scheme, statehood for Jammu and Kashmir, and legal guarantee to minimum support price, among others. Diplomatic tensions with Malé and Islamabad was also highlighted in the election promises, as the Congress promises to repair relations with Maldives and engage with Pakistan over its ability to end cross-border terrorism.
Rigged hai. Isliye bahut zaruri hai ki janta इस बात को समझे कि ये नॉर्मल चुनाव नहीं है, ये लोकतंत्र को बचाने का, संविधान को बचाने का चुनाव है और इसको लड़ना और जीतना बहुत जरूरी है। ये चुनाव 2-3%, 5% और बाकी हिंदुस्तान के बीच में चुनाव है और जो बाकी हिंदुस्तान चाहता है वो इस मैनिफेस्टो में है और जो 2% चाहता है, जो अदानी जी चाहते हैं, वो आप उनका मैनिफेस्टो देख लीजिए, आपको पता लग जाएगा, उसमें उनकी रिक्वेस्ट लिस्ट पूरी की पूरी आपको मिल जाएगी।
Responding to the promises by Congress in its manifesto, PM Modi's ruling BJP said the Congress, which had ruled the country for nearly 4 decades, is talking about Nyay, but its government had not done any justice in their tenure. BJP spokesperson Sudhanshu Trivedi, taking a dig at the Congress, said the grand old party is moving from being old to oblivion.
देखिए कितनी मजेदार बात है, इन्होंने अपने घोषणा पत्र का नाम रखा है न्याय पत्र, मतलब 55 साल तो अन्याय किए हैं मान लिए हैं, मतलब कोई नई नवेली पार्टी होती, अजब अलबेली पार्टी जो इस समय भारत की राजनीति की सबसे नई पार्टी है, जिसके आगे वो पुरानी धुरानी और नई नवेली दोनों मिलके एक हो गए हैं, वो एक बार कहती तो समझ में आता था। आपका इतना बड़ा बैगेज और ये आप कहने का प्रयास कर रहे हैं इसलिए।
मूविंग ऑन, पॉलिटिकल एक्टिविस्ट फ्रॉम POK एंड गिलगित बल्तिस्तान वॉइस कंसर्न एट द UNHRC इन जिनेवा ओवर द प्रेजेंस ऑफ टेरर कैंप्स एंड डिनायल ऑफ बेसिक ह्यूमन राइट्स इन पाकिस्तान्स ऑक्यूपाइड टेरिटरीज। टेक अ लुक।
Members of the United Kashmir People's National Party, UKPNP, held a conference on the sidelines of the UNHRC session in Geneva this week, where they raised concerns about the presence of terror camps in POK and increasing rise of fundamentalism. The activists also highlighted that residents of Pakistan-occupied Kashmir and Gilgit-Baltistan have been struggling due to denial of basic human rights like education, health, employment, and infrastructure development.
क्योंकि ये एक पूरी दुनिया में खास करके आवाम की एक बड़ी अक्सरियत जो पीस लविंग है, जो पुरअमन रहना चाहती है, जो अपने हकूक चाहती है, टेररिज्म की वजह से उनकी राइट्स की मूवमेंट बुरी तरीके से मुतासर हुई हैं, डेमोक्रेसीज अंडर थ्रेट हैं।
The political activists from POK and Gilgit Baltistan have been voicing their concerns at various international platforms, but the silence of organizations like the United Nations worries them.
The International Monetary Fund has said there is strong expectation that Sri Lanka will reach a deal with its commercial creditors by the completion of the IMF second review. Sri Lanka is in talks with bondholders to restructure about $12 billion in debt, a key step in its bid to emerge from a punishing financial crisis. IMF spokesperson Julie Kozak said there's a strong expectation that agreements with commercial creditors consistent with program parameters will be reached by completion of the second review. The IMF reached a staff-level agreement with Sri Lanka on its second review of a 4-year bailout program late last month. But it still needs approval from the IMF's board. And a herd of tuskers in Tiruchirappalli forest area in southern India rejoice as they went through their newly implemented summertime routine, which comprises multiple baths, walks and hydrating meals of sickle and fodder and watermelons. The rehabilitation center, founded in 2019, is currently home to 11 tuskers who have been rescued from owners who possessed them illegally or were unable to take care of them. Summers in India are a difficult time where soaring temperatures lead to numerous casualties for humans as well as animals.
We are actually giving elephants for shower bath, then mud bath, then there are swimming pools. We are allowing the elephants in the swimming pool. And actually, we are giving more succulent fodder, green fodder, in the hot hour of the day.
Meanwhile, authorities of a geological park in western Pune city have also made special arrangements like installation of fans, foggers and coolers to keep animals healthy and comfortable. Rising temperatures adversely affect the metabolic rate of animals. The first impact is apparent through a reduced appetite.
When the temperature it nears up to 40 degrees Celsius, definitely it would have some impact on the animals which are housed in the cages and the exhibits. So accordingly, we do some changes in the form of we putting up fans, coolers, foggers, wherever possible.
The Gallo tribal community in India's northeastern Arunachal Pradesh celebrated its Mopin festival on Friday, marking the onset of harvest season. The members of the tribe donned white traditional attire and smeared each other's faces with rice flour paste made from harvested paddy to mark the agricultural festival. As part of the festivities, they danced and sang hymns dedicated to goddess Mopin Ane, who is believed to bring prosperity and good health. The Gallo community resides in the remote hilly terrains of Arunachal Pradesh and have been listed as a scheduled tribe group since 1950 in India.
ये अंतिम को पिंटे को हम लोग इनवाइट कर रहा है, तो ये वर्ल्ड का हर एक जनजाति के लिए, पॉपुलेशन के लिए अनाज का भंडार होना चाहिए। ये है सब वर्ल्ड में सब आदमी का फास्ट, भूखा पेट मरने का नौबत नहीं आना है। इसके लिए अनिपिंकू पिंटे को हम लोग सोप्सिस अच्छा होके आना है बोल के हम लोग आज रिक्वेस्ट कर रहा है मैंने पूजा कर रहा है.
That's all in tonight's edition. We'll see you same time next week. Have a great weekend. Good night. TAG TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.